Sunday morning, I thought I'd take you out to the industrial section where I live. And I thought I'd show you where you can get some free skids. I was laying them out on the side of the road, and I want to get some free skids so that I can build a potato box for this season. See if we can find any. I'm not gonna be able to record too much while I'm driving because it's three in the tree, so it's hard to shift with one hand and steer. That was the weekend, so a lot of these guys have already picked up a lot of the skids and might not get lucky today. Today might be a learning lesson. Might have to go out on a Friday night to pick up skids. These guys burn them and pits out back, or sometimes they'll burn them at their campsites, so have to see if we can find any. Not getting very lucky today as far as the skids go. Like I said, here's a skid here. It's not a very good one. But it's a start. Throw this in the back of the truck. It's a start, but it's Sunday, so a lot of guys will come around already and collect a lot of the skids to burn or to burn and put in the campfire, burn at home. Let's see what else we can find. Well, we're back at home now. Didn't make out all that well with the skids. We only got one. I'll have to go out on Friday and get some more before they're all gone for the weekend. But luckily I keep some skids here, so got a couple. Got a couple of skids, and that will make a start. get some more skids. And I continue the project, and I guess this would be more than a one-part series. This is the small garden that we started this year. It's, believe it or not, it's mostly a tomato plant. Got a little carried away. But we got some cucumbers and some carrots down in there, and tomatoes, and up front we got some, a couple lemon trees growing, and we got some jalapeno peppers, and I don't know. For the first time, it's not doing too bad. We got some big ones in here. It's waiting for them to ripen up. But anyway, back to the skids. Got a couple here. We managed to pick up a couple, or one anyway. And next Friday I'll go get some more and continue on the project. But we'll start it today with the foundation and the basic framework. So today, like I said earlier, we're gonna build a potato box. And we didn't get too lucky with the skids over in the industrial section, but we'll try again next Friday and see how that goes. Luckily, I have a couple skids here, so this is what we're going to be working with today, and we're going to be building the potato box here beside the garden. Makes the most sense. The best place in the yard. I can build it and it's out of the way, and it's still gonna get plenty of sunlight during the day. Maybe not today because it's kind of overcast, but it's still a really nice day. Anyway, so you can see on the skids you got the three posts here, and we're gonna use them as corner pieces, and we're gonna build the potato box about the same size as the skid. That way there's not too much cutting going on. I hope the audio on this video works out pretty good. But anyway, we should have enough room, or enough wood here, I mean, to get the first layer, or the first rows down, and I'll show you what I mean by that when we get at it. Disassemble the skids, these skids in particular are 47 inches. So that's how wide the potato box is going to be. skids are free. Remember, nothing in life is free. Thanks for that one. Okay, you know all about hard work, don't you?
Yeah, good. That's what you
do. Guy's a hard working dog.
Right?
Yes. You sit. Sit. Now, I peened over the nails. I could have popped them out, and the majority of them, actually, believe it or not, would have came out straight. I've done it before. Save them, you know, reuse them later on. But for this project, we don't care if it's pretty. It doesn't need to be pretty. Later on, you'll see that you'll take the box apart, so none of it needs to be pretty. And because you have to take it apart later on, I'm going to use screws when I do put it together. Right. Screws will be a lot easier to take it apart later.
Kisses.
Peel teething. Thank you. have it. The beginning stages of the potato box. Remember, this is only two skids worth. Actually, this is only one skid. So this is one skid, and we got four posts out of it. Posts that nail the skids together with. And then these are the boards. And I kept them, I mean, this potato box, you know, probably could have been a little bit smaller. But if you're Irish like I am, and you like potatoes, this is a good size. Basically, what the idea is, and I will show you, is you take your potatoes, you fill this up with dirt, and you plant your potatoes. And when the potatoes start to grow, and they start to come out of the ground, you want to put more boards on here, and then you bury the potatoes again. And when they come out of the ground again, and they're coming over the edge, again, you throw more boards on, and you come up a little higher, and then you bury the potatoes again. And you repeat this process, more dirt on top of the buried plants, more boards, and you keep repeating this process until you're up to the top, and the plants are coming over the edge again. And by this time, you should be able to take the boards completely off the front end, pull the dirt out, and it should be jam-packed with potatoes. At least that's the theory. Grand prize winner who gets. All right, guys, so back to the potato box. I'm going to show you some potatoes right now. And on these potatoes are what you call eyes. Potato will grow an eye on it, and they'll grow more than one. Let's see, this potato only has really one. You can see, you can kind of see where it's going to grow some more here later on. But like, here's a potato. It's got a pretty big eye on it. I'll show you what you do with the eyes. So here's one that's got one here starting. And it's got one here starting. And what you want to do is you want to cut the potato. Where that eye is. Walmart presents the weekly shop. The weekend is here. Time to spend the whole day in the car. Kid stuff, grown up stuff, grocery stuff. Just like that. So cut it down like this. And then once this is cut, what you want to do is you want to take this and you want to leave it. And you leave it for a day. And what will happen is this kind of glazes over and will turn almost like a yellowish color. You leave it out. And you leave it for a day, like I said, and it will glaze over. And wherever there's eyes, like here, so with a potato, you can get several potato seeds, as they call them. And basically, you just plant. You plant it. So each of these you would plant in the soil. Plant in your potato box. Each of them is a seed. Clean this one off a little. I don't think there's any more eyes on this one. This one's pretty rotten. Here's an eye here. Just gonna cut where that eye is here. You may not hear my Cut here. Where this eye is. I'm gonna cut this out here. Let's ride. Toss that aside. This one's got an eye. Looks like it just has the one. This one's got two on it. I don't know what you guys will wear lately, at least this season anyway. Potatoes don't seem to be doing all that well. Buying them from the grocery store and they keep rotting fairly quickly. It's almost like they're coming to the grocery store half rotten. Hey, look at this guy here. So there's another eye there. I don't know if this eye will pick up or not. But out of a few potatoes, you can get quite a few potato seeds. Each of these get planted in the dirt after a day. And like I said, you want to set them out for a day, and what you'll get is a yellowy glaze over the potato here. And when that happens, it's the potato's basically almost trying to heal itself. When that happens, then they're good, ready to plant. So I'm going to set them out, and when they glaze over, then we'll plant them in the soil.